Hey there, I'm Patrick Carroll. Welcome to the Affinity Group Virginia Culinary Center. Our culinary center was designed to showcase our clients' products to customers just like yourself. This video is part of a series that highlights our products and how you may use them in your operation. Hey folks, Patrick Carroll here with Affinity Group. I got my good buddy, Mr. Don Prince with me. We're gonna talk about one of our clients today called Renwood Mills. So Renwood Mills is a family-owned company. They've been around for about 75 years. They're out of Hickory, North Carolina. They source all of their ingredients from local farmers in Virginia, North Carolina, and South Carolina. So today we're gonna specifically talk about two of their most popular items, and those are biscuit mixes. We're in the South, everybody loves biscuits. Formula L biscuit mix over here to the left, and then you've got their old-fashioned complete biscuit mix over here to the right. So now both of these biscuit mixes come ready to roll. All you have to do is add one ingredient, and that is buttermilk. So very easy to use while still getting a scratch-made quality biscuit. Another difference between these two items, or really the only difference between these two items, is the shortening mix that they add to them. So if you look here on this black plate, you'll see Formula L is this one right here. And you can see there are yellow shortening chips in there. And you get the baked, when it's baked, you get a nice kind of buttery color and flavor to it. Over here to the right is the old-fashioned biscuit mix, and they use white shortening chips in this product. So it's really more for an eye appeal, customer preference. They both are gonna bake up very moist. Those shortening chips are gonna bake into the biscuit really, really well. It's kind of like some customers like to use black pepper in their fried chicken. Some customers like to use white pepper in their fried chicken. So it's really more just what you wanna see when that biscuit is done and it's going out for service. So Don now is gonna talk about some of these beautiful recipes that he came up with for using the biscuit mixes in addition to just making a simple old biscuit.
So we did the old-fashioned complete biscuit mix, the ready mix, and we did the Formula L, making both rolled out 2 ounce portioned cut out biscuits. And then we also used some drop biscuits. We made up the pot pie, the chicken pot pie, using the Formula L, the Vanni pulled chicken, the Vanni cream of chicken soup, and mixed vegetables. Just kind of mixed up all the soup mixes and stuff and did a drop on the biscuits on top of that and baked them off. And then with the biscuits here, we used the old fashioned to make kind of our version of the Red Lobster drop biscuit mix. And that was pretty much, again, just making the recipe, adding some of the different ingredients and dropping them on a tray, baking them off. This one is a fan favorite at the Georgia State Fair. So I just made that using biscuit mix, some sugar, and some milk, and mixed it up, laid it on there, put the layer of peaches on top of it, and let the biscuits bake over the top of them for a nice cobbler. And then we use the Dole peaches for that one as well. I'm gonna turn it over to Patrick for some of the cost breakdown.
Yep, and so all these biscuits that you see here, so from start to finish, they should take around 10 minutes. Now that includes prep time, adding in your one ingredient of the buttermilk, and cutting the biscuits, or doing a drop biscuit just like you see here where you just scoop the batter right onto a baking tray. So you're looking at around 10 minutes. If you compare that to some of our competitors, so if you're making the biscuits completely from scratch in the back of the house, if you're using a frozen puck or a frozen pre-made biscuit, it's gonna take you almost double that time. Those frozen pucks and frozen pre-mades take anywhere between 15 and 20 minutes in the oven. These are gonna take about 7 to 8 minutes in the oven, and you're gonna get a beautiful biscuit just like you see here today. So the other thing to look at is gonna be cost comparison, right? So this biscuit here from the old fashioned, and then this biscuit over here from the Formula L, it's gonna be right around 12 cents. So very cost effective. There's a really easy way to make money on that if you menu it. And then if you wanna take it even a step further, you could cut that in half and do a drop biscuit. So it's a little bit smaller portion, and you cut your cost down to about 6 cents per biscuit. If you compare that to, again, those pre-made options that I was mentioning earlier, a pre-made frozen puck is gonna be about 20 cents, and then a pre-baked frozen biscuit is gonna be about 30 cents. So again, a lot harder to make money on those. And these are very simple to use for even the most unskilled kitchen worker like myself, who does not like to bake at all. I was still able to come up with some pretty good looking biscuits. So kind of to wrap it all together, Renwood Mills, great company, local, based out of North Carolina. And what we really want to focus on is the cost difference and the cost comparison and the money that you can save by just using a biscuit mix and adding one ingredient, and that is buttermilk. And then of course, all the cool different ways that you can use either your leftover mix to make a beautiful cobbler or a nice homemade chicken pot pie as well. So in conclusion, if there's any questions or you guys want more information, please reach out to your local affinity group rep, and we appreciate you listening to us today. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks for joining us today. For more videos and information, please subscribe to our YouTube channel or contact one of our presenters.